Hello friends, it is Brianna, or the voice of Brianna. Welcome to my channel, where we don't necessarily always fix things, but we do make them less broken. I'm just gonna cut right to the chase. I lost my intro footage of me just kind of introducing the video and introducing myself and like saying what the project was all about and stuff like that. So instead of me talking, please enjoy this cringeworthy stock footage of people who look like they know more about what they're doing than I do. What's going on is basically in the title of the video. This is a closet makeover. I will be making over, cleaning up, and refreshing the two closets in the main hallway upstairs. So like I said, I lost all the intro footage, but the footage I do have is just kind of jumped straight into me cleaning. So that's what you're about to see. The only thing you really need to know that is unfortunately lost in the footage that you're not going to see is that I got new shelving to replace the old gross dirty shelving that was already in the closets. On this day, my husband and I had gone to Home Depot. I had measured out the old shelving and I had wooden and MDF board cut to fit in brand new shelving. I had MDF board and solid wood board cut for two of the different shelves because I couldn't find the same material to fit in both of the closets. So that's why one of the closets has wooden boards that I'm going to paint and then the other one has MDF board. It's not a big deal, but sorry about this little mishap. After I'm done blabbing, the video will roll as normal. So to get started, the first thing I am doing is cleaning out my space. So I'm sweeping and I'm gonna vacuum all the just dirt and debris and dust and residue and stuff that's there. I've already removed the old shelves to get them out of my way. We've encountered our first obstacle because no at-home project is complete without obstacles, right? Are we wobbling? So when I measure the shelving in this closet, the original shelves stopped like right there. So it wasn't enough, so I wanted more. So I took measurements and then I added like 15, not 15, sorry. I added about 3.5 inches, which took it up to about 15 inches total of shelving that I would need. And these are the brand new shelves for this closet. And these are the shelves for this one, much bigger. We just tried to fit the shelving, the brand new ones in here, just to see how it fits, and it doesn't fit. And why does it not fit? Because, show you guys this. For some reason, there's molding, door molding is on the inside of the door. And it actually looks like it's just, we can easily just pop it off and make it fit. And so I got Ace, I was like, maybe Ace can figure it out. Maybe Ace can use his big muscles and make the shelves fit in here. But he couldn't make them fit either. And the reason for that is because the molding here is in the way. And so we had two options. We could either cut a little bit off of the back of each of the shelves so that they were just a little bit, like not as deep, a little bit more shallow, or take off the interior molding. Ace actually was like, I'd prefer to take off this interior molding because it's stupid that it's here in the first place. So I actually think I might go ahead and start working on that tonight. All I'd have to do is get a flathead screwdriver, a hammer, and just kind of loosen it up, lift it up, and then I should be able to pop it off. And then the shelf should fit in there just fine. So I think that's what I'm about to do. So all I'm doing right now is I'm using a hammer and a flathead screwdriver to loosen up the frame on the inside of the door so that I can pop it off. I was about to like go and hunt for another screwdriver that doesn't have a detachable thing here to kind of peel off this one because it's starting to come up. But I was like, I'll just use the back of my hammer. I have that. I have tools, like a caveman.
See, it's this one at the top. It's like pushing.
So we have to take all three of them off? Like all the frame? It looks like it has more room already, right?
Yeah.
See, look. Now it fits on this side because we removed that inner framing. But yeah, so once we take this one off, and then I think we'll probably take the one up top off. It should fit. I didn't even film you. Okay, well,
easy day.
I was about to do the whole thing with the screwdriver. Ace just came over and popped it off. So it's off now. Thank you, honey. So big and strong.
Alright, y'all can probably see it from in there. So now, it's gone. It should fit, but I am gonna get it cleaned up. I'm gonna vacuum in here again too, because it's all dirty again. Now that we got the interior frame taken down, which was suspiciously easy, by the way. What if I'm just filling in with spackle? Because I'm looking at, y'all can see it. God, I wish there was a freaking light in here. This space in between here, in between the door and the drywall. So, I think I need to sleep on what I'm gonna do about those gaps in there. I might do nothing about it. I mean, it's not exposed and it's not exposing anything dangerous. So I don't know, I might just leave it. I'll give it a good cleaning and a good sanding too so that there's no like jagged edges from the wood sticking out. Next thing I'm gonna do right now is I'm going to start with a Mr. Clean Magic Eraser and just to wipe down the whole inside of the closet because it's just so gross. So I'm gonna do that first and then I'm gonna follow it up with a disinfectant, like actual, like, clean the germs cleaner.
I went through about three Mr. Clean erasers, cleaning all of it. That wall down there looks way better too. Hello, ma'am. You come and assess my work? Looks good? All right, good job, thank you. Alpha gave me her blessing, so it's good. And now we still have this one. There was no issue, I don't know if I already said this, there was no issue with these shelves, the wooden shelves, fitting in here. Everything fits perfectly. The big thing is this griminess down here. So I'm gonna do what I just did in that one, and I'm going to start by cleaning really well with Mr. Clean Erase. It's probably gonna go through at least four in this closet. That'll be the last thing I do for the evening because I wanna let everything sufficiently dry. And then tomorrow I will sand and paint. So I'll see you guys tomorrow. Hello there, friends. Brianna's back. Last place we left off was I cleaned out both these linen closets. And the next thing I'm gonna do is sand. I have my, where's my sander? Here it is. My electric sander right here. I'm gonna have to get the vacuum cleaner. I mean, cause there's no, I can't do this outside, obviously. So I'm gonna have to get the vacuum cleaner and sleep and mop really good after I'm done. It is what it is. I'm gonna make a mess. So I'm gonna sand really good and then I'm gonna clean again really good and then let things dry out for probably an hour and then I'm going to repaint. I'm pretty sure that the previous owners left a can of like white touch-up paint. I'm gonna go look in the garage. I'm back and I was correct. They're not all the same shades of white, but if I'm being totally honest, it doesn't really matter to me that much if they're not the same shade. Something else that I totally forgot that is part of this project too. So these cabinets, or these shelves, for this one, are already white. However, my shelving for this big one right here, these are the solid wood ones. These I am going to paint white. So what I'm actually gonna do is take these outside and paint them up now. And then like I'll sand and then come back and maybe do a second coat and then I'll paint like that. So that way I can, you know, kind of maximize my time. So we'll take these outside, paint them and then come back inside and then sand. So I just finished up outside, painted one coat of paint on both of the shelves. So while that's drying, I'm going to go ahead and sand this closet. This was a super gross one. Yeah, so we're gonna sand that down really good and then give it a fresh coat of paint. Something that occurred to me as I was sanding is first of all, I don't need to sand the walls. I don't know, it's drywall. I don't know why I was thinking that I need to sand drywall. But I did want to sand this bottom portion. Bring the camera over here. But as you guys know, I did want to get this bottom portion sanded because it was, I mean, it still is gross, but it's not as gross as it was, I don't think. I think it's a lot less gross. And I also noticed as I was sanding, oh wow, it looks way better. Well, it looks better. I don't know about way better, but it does look better. I also noticed that this is not wood. This, you can kind of see, this is particle board. There's also like grains of rice coming up, like flying in my face as I was sanding it, which was weird. So I don't know, this must have been used for like dry food storage. I think I'm gonna lay one coat of paint down and then I have like plastic liner, drawer liners, and I'll just lay that down. Really, I'm just putting the paint down for cosmetic purposes, just so it doesn't look as gross, and then I'll also be painting the edges too. Yeah, so I think that's what we're gonna do. Let's go check on our shelves outside. Okay, so I just went outside to give our shelves a second coat of paint. I think two coats is good. So I'll let them dry for a couple hours. I think I'm gonna get started on painting this one. Onyx, I see your Mike Tyson.
I got the Mike Tyson.
Onyx walked into my brush as I was holding it. And now he has a Mike Tyson tattoo. Oh, baby.
It's okay, man.
It's okay.
It's okay, man.
Okay, so you got it off.
Hold on.
See, it's blending in with his salt.
It's gray, yeah.
I finished painting this closet. So, here's something. Learning experience for Brianna. I think I'm gonna have to touch up some areas. I can kind of see some areas where I don't think I got enough coverage with the roller. And also, this paint smells weird. I've been in a lot of freshly painted homes before, and this paint does not smell like that. I looked at the lid after I already started painting, and this paint is from 2017. So I wonder, does paint expire? I'm so bad at this. I told you guys I was doing my best, okay? It's a good thing this isn't like a large scale project, you know? It's like, I feel like the linen closet was starting small enough where like, it's okay if I mess up a little bit, right? So yeah, it's done. It just looks so much cleaner. It also occurred to me that maybe I should have primed too, but I believe this is a paint and primer. Although, I wonder if the fact that this paint is kind of old, I wonder if that like negates that, I don't know. I think I did okay. Looking forward to seeing the finished product. I'm gonna just let this continue drying. I'll leave this open, the door open, and I'll let this continue drying probably for like at least the next 2 days. And then I'll pop the shelves in there, and then that'll be the finished product. And then the finished product will be when the movers come and bring our stuff, and I can actually like get this all nice and organized. This is a linen closet, so like there's gonna be sheets and towels in here. So what I'm gonna do now is just touch up out here, and I also realize I need to hop back outside, flip my shelves, and do the other side of my shelves, and then I'm gonna come back in, and then I'm going to paint this interior. And also something I completely did not even say, I thought this was white. This is not white. This paint color is actually this paint that's on all the rest of the walls in the house. There's a bit of a story with this one. It still looks spotty because it's still drying, like I just finished this minutes ago. So, the gray paint that I painted that one with, I thought I'd have enough to paint this one with that too. So I kind of did the thing where you start off with the edges before you go in with the roller and get like the bigger parts. And by the time I got done doing all like the edging, I had no more of the grayish paint left. But what I did end up finding was I found another gallon of I found a whole nother gallon downstairs in the garage of just like this flat white. So I decided to just go ahead and use that. And so this little storage closet is going to be white while the other one's gray. And I think that's just fine. I'll leave this open to dry. And I will come back to this tomorrow afternoon. All right, guys, so some time passed and I did exactly what I said I was gonna do. I went outside and went ahead and painted the other side of the shelves for the other linen closet, let them dry. And before I show you like the big reveal, I wanted to just remind you, this is how this smaller closet looked in the before. Pretty dirty, very dirty, kind of gross looking. The paint really needed a refresh and it was just, yeah, it was just gross. And now here is the big reveal. It's been cleaned and scrubbed. It's had a fresh coat of paint. You can definitely see that I made some mistakes. I did use painter's tape on the baseboard in the closet, but I still had some blemishes. You know, I still made some messes a little bit. I would be more inclined to fix it up if it were not a closet, but again, this was a closet. Nobody can see it immediately. So I wasn't too terribly upset at the small mistakes I had made during my painting where I got a little too much paint and got some paint on the baseboard there. Then I put a drawer liner there just for like an extra layer of protection and just to keep the area more clean. I realized I really didn't give a good like solid before for the taller linen closet. So here's my before photo that I took of the other one. Same deal. It's just gross. It's old. The shelves were very short too. And here is the final finished product. This is the fully finished result. I actually have it fully stocked with our linens and stuff like that. I think overall, definitely came out really nice. I actually like the gray paint in there. I think it's nice and soft. And the MDF boards that I had cut are longer, so they are more spacious than the original boards in there. Did make some mistakes on this one as well, but overall pleased with how it turned out. And also, I had a piece of MDF board left over that was too long to go in this closet, but I wanted to use it because, you know, we bought it. So I actually put it in the coat closet downstairs by the front door. I took a handsaw and I cut it down just a little bit, maybe like another 3 or 4 inches just so we could fit. So I replaced that old shelf that was in the linen, that was in the coat closet, with the new MDF board. So here's what that looks like in this closet here. And that concludes our linen closet makeovers, and I guess partially the coat closet. Thank you so very much for watching here on my channel today. If you enjoyed this video, hit the like button. If you super enjoyed this video, why not consider subscribing? I would really appreciate it. Thank you again for watching, and I will see you all in the next one. Bye.